everybody, my name is Shitanshu and I welcome you to my YouTube channel Dream Abroad. In every video of mine I keep telling you the benefits of coming to Canada, getting the PR, you know, the student life in Canada, how to settle in Canada, different types of visas. But this video is quite different because in this video I'm going to tell you about few points that I don't like about Canada, few points that I absolutely hate about Canada. Yes, obviously there are a few points that I don't like about Canada, and in this video I'm going to tell you all of those points. So if you're interested, stay tuned. Okay, before I start this video, let me tell you that my intention is not to demotivate anyone. I uploaded this video, which has actually got 1 million views, by the way. So this video, so many people were commenting that, why are you demotivating us? Why are you still there? Why don't you go back to your home country? You know, stop doing this negative videos. So this is not a negative video. This is just, I'm telling you whatever I feel. And of course, I'll continue making those videos which will help you come to Canada, and I'll make one video about those points that I absolutely love about Canada. But this video is about those points which I dislike or I absolutely hate about Canada. Okay, so the very first thing that I dislike about Canada is its extreme harsh weather and its distance from India as well. So first I'll talk about its distance from India. So you know, I've been to India a couple of times since I've been here in 2017. And you know, almost every flight has been like 20 hours 21 hours. You don't get to feel if you're having the breakfast, if you're having a lunch, or if you're having a dinner. I mean, during one time zone, you know, a few hours earlier, you're in different time zone, you know, after 6 hours, you don't know what's the time in India, you don't know what's the time in Canada. It's so confusing. So this was one little point. The other point is, of course, the harsh weather. Of course, you know that Canada is super cold in the months of December, January, February, March. You know, this is even April and it is cold here. You know, today is a good day, it's a bright sunny day, so I'm out, you know, shooting this video. But you know, usually in April also, you know, I shot one video last 15th April 2018. There's a snowstorm over here, so this is something that, you know, I don't like. Obviously, you know, nobody likes it because you know, in the first few snowfalls, you would like it, you know, you would click pictures, it would look so beautiful. But after that, you know, because it's so cold outside, you know, temperature goes, you know, down to minus 30 degrees, minus 40 degrees at some places. So it is very difficult to go out at these temperatures and do any kind of activities apart from skiing. Yes, if you have the car, you have a slight advantage that, of course, you know, you just sit in the car, sit in your heated seats, and then you can roam around here and there. But then if there's a snowstorm, you know, it gets very difficult because the roads are very slippery, and you know, I've seen so many accidents. So yes, the first point, the distance from my country India, and the weather. Okay, now I'm going to talk about the second point, which is the healthcare system. Yes, you must have heard all the good things about the healthcare system in Canada. You know, it's free of cost. You know, you can go to any hospital, you know, you can get treated, you can get the best treatment, world-class treatment, free of cost. Yes, that is all true. That is all true. I'm not denying that fact. But the fact that you have such long queues in the hospital, you know, it is really, really disappointing. So last year, one of my friends was actually suffering from the pain of kidney stone, and you know, some of you might know that it's like really, really, really painful. So we took him to the hospital. You know, we were there in the emergency ward. Obviously, she diagnosed it that the problem is kidney stone, so she gave her a few painkillers, and after that, we were waiting there for almost 3 hours. Can you believe, in the emergency ward for 3 hours? Because the take is that you're not gonna die with this pain, right? You have to bear this pain. So I mean, if you're going to emergency ward, you know, the healthcare system in India, obviously you have to pay a lot of money, but at least you can get the urgent care, you know, if you feel that kind of a pain, or if you have any that if you have any kind of a problem. But here, you know, you have to get long queues. After, you know, she after he was actually admitted inside the hospital. He was lying there on the bed for a few hours, and it was like, three, four more hours that probably, after 6 or 7 hours, he got doctors attending him and he got the medicines, of course, apart from the painkillers that he was getting regularly. So this is one thing. And of course, if you want to go for a specialist appointment, if you have any problem, somewhere, any problem, you want to go for a specialist doctor, the appointments which you'll get would be like, few weeks from today. So if you want to go for a heart surgeon, and you don't have a serious problem, like a emergency kind of a problem, in that case, you would get the appointment probably after, 3 or 4 weeks. There's a long, long queue over there for the specialist. And also for tests like MRI, CT scan, there's a long, long queue over there. So this is the second point that I don't like about Canada. All right, it brings me to my third point. It's the taxation system and insurance. It is so high over here. Taxes, you need to pay, at least 30 to 40% taxes, of the income taxes. You need to pay 13% HST. So the taxes are so high over here that you actually feel that you are giving a lot of money to the government, but of course you do get a lot of things in return. You get such a good lifestyle over here, you get the quality life, so you get what you pay for, as they say. So this is very true over here. Apart from taxes, the insurance part is also a huge deal, because if you talk of getting a home over here, you have to get a home insurance. If you have to get a car, probably you'll end up paying like something like $200 to maybe $250 as the insurance, and that is per month. So this is another point which I dislike about this place. You have to pay such heavy taxes. Of course, you get free education, free healthcare, only because you pay such heavy taxes. Okay, now it brings me to the fourth point. Now this is quite unique, you probably won't hear it from many people. It is the delivery system here. I mean, what do I mean by delivery system? So if you if you order a package from Amazon, people would come to your home. The courier people would come to your home, and they would, if it's big in size, if you're not there at your home, they won't call you. They will actually, stick a sticker over there, which would, quote your name and your address, and it will say that you actually missed this delivery. We came over here, you were not here, so we would, attempt the delivery again tomorrow. And if you miss it for, a couple of days, actually, the package would go back. This is something which is quite annoying. I mean, it could be simplified very easily, like we have in India. People coming in, they just call you if you're there, if you're around there. They can ask for a convenience time, and then obviously they can deliver the package. But here it is certainly not the case. And apart from the Amazon packages, there are a few other important deliveries which can come your way, like your PR card or credit cards, things like that. Now, when your PR card comes, there's no tracking number. It can come through, the government is actually sending it. So they have the Canada Post, under their name. So they can actually send it through, a proper tracking courier service, right? But they don't send it through a tracking courier service. You cannot track that package. You have to wait. You cannot do anything about it. You can just call them and you can ask them if they have delivered it, if they have actually dispatched it or not. So this is another thing which is something that I don't like about Canada. Okay, so this brings me to the last point, and that point is actually the housing prices over here. Now, I came to Waterloo, and this place was quite cheap in terms of housing prices in the year of 2017. Now, even here, the housing prices are going sky high. You would get a two bedroom for something around 1800, 1700 to 1800, which is actually high in terms if you think of Waterloo or Kitchener area. Because if you talk of if you talk of Toronto area, of course it is super expensive. So all those people who are coming to thinking of moving to Toronto, there's a bad news for you that the apartment or the rent prices actually go up every year, and they are at all time high at this moment. Probably you would get a one bedroom apartment or a condominium for something like $1,800. If you want to go for a two bedroom apartment, it would cost you something like $2,600, $2,800 or even higher. So this is another point which no one here likes, and of course I also dislike.